With 38 years in power, those who are poor should be able to see light and come out of poverty. Okiswa said all the 32 parishes in Arua district have all received the shillings 100 million with a directive for each beneficiary to receive at least shillings 1 million for a guided agricultural production.
What next is poverty must be eradicated, and that is now the country we all cherish. And now we have already dispersed all the 100 million which is meant per parish.
Boniface Alioni, the NRM vice chairman, Arua, is pleased with the democratic grounds provided for the people to elect leaders of their interest. Citing improved infrastructure, Alioni says the challenge remains for the government to fight corrupt officials who deprive the people of better service delivery.
The corruption in the government is still very, very high. I think we have put, as a ruling party, we have put very good energy in building the security. But now we need to mobilize another energy in combating corruption. There is corruption from the top.
Meanwhile, Moses Obeta, the chairman, business community Arua, applauds the government for maintaining peace and security of the country, which has enabled conducive platform for business to operate. He, however, calls on government to ensure investors do not take over the business for retailers and other small suppliers.
By 2030, we expected most Ugandans to be in the middle income range, but we don't know if this can be true. If you see in the current business environment, so many people are dropping out. So many people are losing capital. So many people are losing businesses. Why? Because of unfavorable competition that we have in the business environment.
Ronald Debo, the chairman, Chamber of Commerce, Arua City, commends the government for fighting numerous wars in northern Uganda, which has provided good trading grounds for the people in West Nile region.
But the challenges are still there. As we said, infrastructure, the road, a problem. Industrial power, they have to do it. They have to maintain this security. This security, you can't say you have achieved security, you go and sleep. It is a continuous process. So they have to ensure that this security remains okay.
The Member of Parliament for Arua Central Division, Jackson Lee Buti Atima, is pleased with boosted economy and improved infrastructure, development and security in the East African community, championed by the NRM government.
Before this year ends, West Nile will be led to national grid, which will now spur development, which will attract industrialization in the region, which will create jobs for our youth and women in this region. So in as far as electricity is concerned, we are well to go.
Call them the imperialists, people who have an imperialist spirit, who want us not to refine our oil, who want us to just, you know, export crude oil. And our leader has said no. He's saying the wealth from the oil will come to this country.
Ham Ezama Muzamil, the Deputy Resident City Commissioner, Arua, notes that small pockets of insecurity caused by thugs and evasion of tax by smugglers affects service delivery.
Only that our business members in the community, they don't want to impress willingness in paying the taxes and so on. That's why you see the struggle with the URA team, like issues of smuggling and so on. You know, when people start invading taxes, it also affects the service delivery.
West Nile became part of Uganda in 1914 from the then Boga Zaire, but faced numerous insurgencies that have been fixed, and this largely has been attained under the NRM government in power for the last 38 years. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.